If you want to talk about the past, I have a great photo of you growing up where you frosted your hair, and that's definitely talking about the past right there. Well, how did this happen?
So,
what boy band were you in again? I forget.
God,
that's
when did
not
you do
awkward
this?
At all.
No, it's not embarrassing to look at. No.
So, just you keep it up.
I'm going to. Yeah, but you did this to yourself, though?
Yes.
No, I mean, like, this is a self frost? A home frost? Is it a home frost or is it a salon frost?
It was an at-home group event with my other buddies.
Okay.
So we would literally go to, like, the drug mart and get this. You put this cap on. And you get this long stick with a tiny hook, and you put it in the cap, and you pull out strands of hair.
So your hair comes out almost like those Play-Doh things where you squeeze the barbershop and the hair is pressed out. Yeah, and that's it right there.
And then you put bleach on it, and that's obviously the beauty of it.
Yeah, and that's... And after all these fights, that's how you end up getting into hockey. And that's, fantastic.
Yeah.
And so you didn't end up playing hockey. You went into acting.
Right.
And I'm glad, we're all glad that you did, because you're a fantastic actor. And here you are in this movie, The Normal Heart, based on the play.
Yeah.
Gosh, I saw the play.
Yeah.
It knocked me out. I did not know that this is, it's just so real. And it makes me think, like, I can't believe this only happened, you know, 30 years ago.
Yeah.
It's like happened in the 1980s.
Yeah, the film starts when I was born in 81, and it's based on the AIDS epidemic. Yeah.
I was born 82, sorry. I was born 80.
Right, my bad. That was on me.
I remember hearing Pac-Man sounds when I was waking up. I was a baby. I was like, ah. I was like hearing people, Anyway, 80,
So it's a decent cast.
Decent. Yeah, exactly. You were in the best company ever.
And really am.
But to see in this play, I mean, I couldn't even believe it. This is when just no one knew what AIDS was.
No idea. They're calling it gay cancer.
Gay cancer is what they thought. I mean, it's like, it's serious. This is really what they were doing. And all people's friends are just dying. You're going, what is going on? And like even like in hospitals, nurses were afraid to go in and take care of...
Quarantined. I play Bruce Niles, who ends up being the president of the gay men's health crisis. And he's actually was in the closet as well. So the duality that goes with that was incredible to play. And I think this is what this clip is.
Yeah, I want to show this is an amazing Ruffalo's performance. Mark Ruffalo's coming into the scene as well. Here we have a clip. Here's Taylor Kitsch in The Normal Heart. Take a look at this.
I want to introduce you to our gay president, who's in the closet. And he's so handsome, don't you think? Such a very handsome cover boy, going to waste. Oh, great. Now you fight. Great. Fight, Bruce.
You make me sound like a coward, and I'm not a coward. You know what? You have nothing to lose. Your brother invests for you, so you have income. You can be gay 24/7, Ned, but I can't. I can't. So, you.
No. You, Bruce.
Passionate movie. It's, you won't believe it. When you see it, you're just going to be just floored by all the performances. It's a fantastic job done by everybody.